Hello, my Tubies, my Teletubbies. As you see, I'm here. No, don't think I'm this fat. I'm not this fat. It's a daishiki. It's a daishiki. Well, some people call them moomoos. You know, whatever. I'm getting ready to share it with you. Actually, Narcissist, the name of this topic is going to be called, let me put my glasses on. Narcissist will never appreciate a strong woman. They will never appreciate a strong woman. I haven't eaten yet. You know, I said I was going to cook some steak and potatoes in my crock pot. We're going to do a mukbang. We can still do a mukbang as we listen to you know who, my baby, Derek Jackson. And like I said, he is the author of so many books. These are the ones that I purchased. The one called A Cheating Man's Heart. He has book 1 and 2. Don't Forget Your Crown. The queen that you are, and I don't mean drag queen. I still want it, and Single Mothers Are for Grown Men. So he has a couple of other books. You can get them on Amazon because I have them on my Kindle. I like to read on my Kindle because I can highlight, I could do notes and all the above. Anyway, while we're listening to this, I'm going to be heating up my dinner. I didn't make the steak that I said I was going to do, but I have the steaks here, and what I do with these is I cut them in nice strips, strips. I got another nice piece here that I was supposed to put in my crock pot. As you see, I was supposed to put that in my crock pot and with some potatoes. I always put 3 potatoes, cut them in half, put them right in there. And with these nice chuck steaks, you cut them in strips. I buy it thick, like you could actually have the supermarket people cut it up for you. But I got these from Aldi, and Aldi don't do that. But anyway, I have these for when I decide to cut them up. I'm kind of tired right now. I also have some nice salmon. I'm having my son over tomorrow, and I'm very happy about that. Now, like I said, for all of those who are gluten intolerant, they have these amazing gluten-free seasoning. This is what I use for my son. My daughter is also can't tolerate gluten. So, yeah, I have to keep that in mind if I ever see her again, whatever. But this is my son, and I have this nice salmon. Isn't that nice? Take a look at that price for this big old thing. $12.23. I'm going to cut that up real nice. I don't know if I should fry it, but I think I'll use my toaster oven. And I'll season it up really nice. You have these seasonings all in one. You have this one that I use with my son. And I have these. These are all salt-free. This one is salt-free and gluten-free. I got them off of Amazon. You know? Yeah. Anyway, I know gluten is not probably good for me either, but I'm not as allergic to it as my children are, my son and my daughter. She can't handle the gluten. My son can't deal with the gluten anymore. I don't know whether they're getting up there in age, but so I'm looking forward to him coming over tomorrow, and I'm going to make him a nice dinner. I'm going to have this, and I'm going to make a salad, and I'm going to have some string beans. I just do meat and vegetables because that's what's safe for people who are gluten intolerant. Yeah, just have the meat and vegetables. And use the gluten-free seasonings. Anyway, let's get popping with Derek Jackson and how he's going to share with us how strong women are a blessing. So while we're listening, I'm going to be heating up my dinner. My chicken that I had yesterday with gravy and mixed vegetables. Let's listen in.
Team Jackson, what's happening? Real quick, man, I want to address my guys. You know, over the last couple of days, I've been hearing some conversation, and it seems that we have a huge misunderstanding when it comes to a strong woman. What's you know, up? These are women that typically we say shit like, oh, you know, she thinks she too independent, or she thinks she don't need no man. Or, see, that's why you got to go to a different country or a different demographic, a different age, a different race in order to find you a woman. Because these women out here, you know what I'm saying, they too difficult to love and to understand. They take too much effort, man. Like, I think that's all rooted in misunderstanding a strong woman. And because we misunderstand strong women, we typically will miss out on what could be one of our greatest blessings. Like, especially when shit get real for us. And every man could attest that things do occasionally get real. Like, you know, you may lose your job. You may lose some money. What? You may lose a good friend. You know what I mean? You may lose a loved one. You may start a business nobody supports. You may just get discouraged, man. Like, whatever it is that can make a grown man cry whenever you...
I hear you, Derek. Excuse me, my darling. But here we are with my beautiful chicken with mixed vegetables, chicken with gravy. This is from yesterday. Thank God. And I'm hungry. Actually, what time is it? It's 9:20. And all I had, don't forget, at lunchtime, all I eat is I have a smoothie. I don't know, for some reason, I wasn't particularly hungry today. To be honest with you, I'm not really all that hungry now, but I know once I start eating, it'll kick in. But anyway, let's get back.
Getting that situation, it's only a strong woman that's going to know what to do and what to say in order to help you keep pushing. Not only help you keep pushing, but in the meantime, it takes for you to recover and to get back on your feet, hold shit down. But these women that y'all are chasing, these easy women, and I'm going to just call it how I see it, that's what it is. It's not their fault that they're easy. It's not their fault that their entire life, you know, they needed somebody to depend on and they had somebody. They looked out for people and those people didn't stab them in the back. They needed money. That money was always there. They needed a listening ear, a shoulder to cry on, and they always had somebody. You know, they didn't have to figure shit out when it didn't seem like things could even be figured out, when it seemed like, you know, there wasn't a solution. They didn't have to just figure something out and make shit happen. Those are the women that are easy. They're just not battle-tested. You know, and the price of getting one of those women, even though they are easy, is that in those times where you need somebody to be strong with you, they're going to do one of two things. Either they're going to, one, abandon ship, or two, break down with you, panic with you, and help you implode. So you choose what you want. You know what I mean? But I feel like if we really properly understood strong women, we would know why it's important to not only understand them, but also make the extra effort that it requires to love them. Like, to love a strong woman, man, you can't really punish and shame her for being strong. And we
thank
do a
you,
lot of that.
Thank you.
Telling women that they're wrong for being strong.
Yeah, I mean, come on. And it happens all the time. They sit up here and they'll sit up here and say that you're not feminine because you are a strong woman who don't fold in the time of crisis or when hardship hits. I was looking at some of the comments from a lot of the women here and the ones that I found to be interesting, sure. Okay, it says, strong women aren't born that way. They're created. Life experiences create a strong woman. Strong women should be honored and respected. Why should we have to be punished or called, like, we're not feminine? You know, who gives a personally? Me? I don't give a damn. You know what I'm saying? Because this other woman, her name is Ruth Gibson. And she makes a really good point here. She says, I'm not strong by choice. I'm strong by obligation. I need to survive because nobody will come to save me. If I was not strong, she said, I would be dead by now. You have to be strong, honey, or you'll be strung out on drugs, or you'll be out there being promiscuous, selling your body. If you're not strong, you'll be sitting up there an alcoholic. I had to calm my drinking down, but you'll be a chronic alcoholic drinking every goddamn day. Look at intervention. Those are women who are not strong. Look at intervention. Go on YouTube. It's on A&E, intervention. And I'll show you alcoholics and I'll show you drug addicts and I'll show you women who are not strong. You have got to be strong in this world. We live in a world that is... You either be strong or you perish or you fall by the wayside. And when it comes to a narcissist, they don't like strong women because you have to keep in mind they always want to feel superior. You know, if they can't feel superior, whatever. But let me see a couple of other things that she said. She says, a lot of men don't understand this, but most strong women I know, they're waiting for the type of guy that will love her enough to make her day. Let her, personally, me, I'm tired of doing the heavy lifting. I'm not really, you know, I'm Moon and Leo and all the above. So what can I tell you? And I'm a Capricorn. That's strong, doubly strong. But it would be nice and refreshing for a man to come along and know how to take the lead and take charge wisely. Personally, I don't feel safe with any of them. I met this new one. He's Hispanic. Well, whatever. And it says here, the other person says, we may be a blessing, but some men don't want a strong woman. Some men have a need to control women and want a woman with no voice, no rights. Some men don't care about the long term until they get older and they need someone to care and take care of them. Now, all of a sudden, they need a strong woman. Mm-hmm. They're older and they need a caretaker. Let's listen back to, I'll read some more of the comments from, I got to get my food off the micro, and we'll do a mukbang to a certain extent, okay? Let's listen in. Come on, Derek, take the lead.
You love a strong woman, you compliment her strength. You be that place that she can be vulnerable. You be that place of peace and relief. You know, where she's had to carry so many burdens her entire life, looking out for everybody else, not having nobody else to reach out to, not having nobody else that could help her, that would help her. You be that place of vulnerability that you help her carry burdens that normally she would bear on her own. And even though she can bear them on her own, even though she can do these things by herself, as her man, you let her know that now she does have help. Another way that you love a strong woman is realizing that they don't always take good care of themselves mentally and emotionally. And as a man, you may have to step in and make sure.
I like the point that he made when it says, even though she knows how to handle it, and she can handle this, she can, you know, really. So walk in the park, because she was raised that way, you know. I was raised with a mother who had 5 boys, and I was the only girl, 6 children. My mom was strong. You know, she was looking for love in all the wrong places, if you will, was taken advantage of. But I saw how my mom, she handled it. She worked. And even though she was working, sometimes she had to get a little extra help from public assistance. But she was a hardworking woman. She even went and got her GED. I saw how she handled sometime when my brothers, a woman trying to raise 5 men, how when they was trying to come out of pocket on my mom, how she handled it. She was a strong woman. I saw my mom when men was sitting up here trying to be abusive to her. My mom was a fighter. She was like, that ain't happening. I also saw how my mom, she didn't let no man use her for money. You ask my mother for money? She was, my mom was highly offended. She was highly offended. Let me put this down a little bit. Don't ask my mother for no damn money. And you're supposed to be a man, and she's supposed to have some kind of respect for you. No. Mom, excuse me, she would be getting rid of you in a heartbeat. And I was raised with a strong woman. And I love my mom. I admire her. Her sign was Aquarius. Her moon was in Capricorn. I didn't know that. I did my mom's chart. She was born February 2nd, 1935. My mom would be like 83. If she was still alive. But I was raised with a strong mother. Sitting up here backing down to some clown, sitting up here trying to take advantage of me. Are you crazy? And I'm still supposed to have respect for him and let him be the head of the household? That ain't happening. Anyway.
Sure that she's taking care of herself. Help her take care of herself by planning those vacations and those spa dates. It ain't all about spoiling and splurging. Like, loving a strong woman doesn't look like buying a whole lot of expensive shit. But it may look like telling them, take the day off. Or on your day off, no, you don't have to do any of the things you would normally do. I already got it planned out. You got 4 hours at the spa. You got nails. You got hair. Thank I just you. Want you to go treat yourself.
Hello.
Just
go take some time. I get to get my hair done, my nails done. I get to go to the spa. Thank you. Bravo. Bravo.
To yourself, self-preservation matters. But the thing is, strong women tend to put themselves on the back burner. So a man that wants to love them will have to put her at the top of his priority list in order to properly love her. So again, you can get one of these women that's easy to love, easy to get, but you're going to miss out on the woman that's valuable to have over the long term. So y'all let me know what your thoughts are in the comments. I'll let y'all.
That's nice. He actually wants to know our thoughts. He cares about how we feel about it. I like this guy. I just wish I could find an older version of him. He's like in his 30s. I think he's like 37. And I've heard women make negative comments about Derek Jackson. And it goes in one ear and out the other. I don't want to hear it. The man is on point. I think he's single. He's looking for the right one for him. You know, I love this dude, man. Some person say, oh my God, you are on point. People, don't you dare sleep on Derek. What else is some? Not too many of us have self-worth anymore. Being strong and knowing who you are is beyond beautiful, ladies. I say keep up the good work, whatever. This other woman, she says her name is Queen Toki. She says, Lord knows I'm a strong woman. Men don't appreciate me at all. I'm always rejected and looked over. In my heart, I know it's for my own good because God has something just right for me. But in my mind, see, her heart knows that, but in her mind, I'm just lonely and not understanding why he refuses to see the great woman in me. But one of these days, I'll be posting my wedding date under one of your videos. I just believe God, even in my anguish. Why do you have to have one of these days I'm going to be married? Why is that the do-all, the be-all, and all, end-all? No, one of these days, I'm going to have amazing roommates like the Golden Girls, and I'm going to definitely, you know, get what God has planned for me. Why does it always have to be surrounded by I got to have a man, I got to have a dude? No. No. One of these days, I'm going to find the perfect roommates, and we're going to have the, here I go with fantasy, right? The perfect life, and it's going to be great, man. Freak that, oh, I got to have a man, or I can't be happy. That's nuts. Okay, what else? And this woman says, what's the deal with guys who want a yes, yes woman? What's wrong with a strong woman? These soft, weak women, they can't cope with their man suffer when he suffers or when he has a catastrophic health issue. What about when he has a job loss and he's stressed? And what about life's general BS? A real strong man, he wants a strong woman. I think personally, my view is a king, he wants a queen. If you're a queen, the king is not always going to be at his best. He's going to have off days. You have to be a queen enough to know how to handle that and run this. You're going to have to know how to run this. And you're going to have to know how to speak with authority to get things done. Now, if you this weak, little, mousy, passive type of broad, yeah, good luck with that. A real strong man knows how to appreciate a strong woman because he understands he can't carry all the weight all the time. That's what I just said. Anyway, my tubies, as you see, we're having our little muck bank. Boy, I can't believe I'm eating so late. I'm not supposed to eat after 8 o'clock. None of that means I can't eat tomorrow until at least 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Because I like to do that intermittent fasting. You know how when you cook something, and you leave it in the refrigerator the next day so the seasoning gets even more into it. Tubies, I really, really wish I could have you over so you could enjoy this chicken gravy and mixed vegetables. It is outrageous. Anyway, do I have any other videos to make tonight? I have my little list here. Topics for discussion for my mukbangs. I made a list of all the things we're going to talk about. See that? You can pause this and see all the things we're going to talk about. See all of that? We're going to talk about this on my mukbangs. So that way I can listen and still eat. Anyway, I love you, as you know. We'll definitely talk again. I'm going to finish up this meal, and then I'm going to go and relax. I think I'm going to call my girl. She's called me a couple of times, but I've been so consumed. She probably thinks I don't love her, and I've been ignoring her. That's so not the case. I've just been so busy. I've got to call her tonight before 10 o'clock. I like to call people before 10. Anyway, let me put that aside. Anyway, I love you. Until next time, we will definitely talk again. Good night, darlings.